AIM Journal's Andrew Hore with me in the studio this afternoon. Andrew, nice to see you. Welcome back.
Hello.
Busy week for IPOs. We've had Boku, City Pub, of course. We spoke about Boku last time
in
the studio.
Yes, I mean, it's the business that does the technology which enables people to pay for things via their mobile rather than having to type in their payment card details and everything. And it came at a pretty high valuation. It's I think it's about 125 million it was valued at 59 pence, and it's already gone up to 81 pence. So that's about 170 million pounds for something that's losing money at the moment. But it's very highly operationally geared because they've got overheads which they don't really have to increase. It's just a question of getting more payment, more people to use their technology, the more payments go through, they only get a tiny bit of revenue, but that tiny bit of revenue mounts up over time. And looking at the Peel Hunt forecasts, they were expecting a big increase in revenue, more than double revenue up to 2020, but they expected also to go from a loss to a profit, operating profit of well over $20 million. But even then, it's sort of you're still trusting that they're going to make those figures, and it's still reasonably high rating considering 2020 is, 3 years away still.
And CityPub?
Yeah, CityPub, this is a bunch of people like David Bruce who've set up lots of these kind of businesses. The last one was Capital Pub, which was bought by a much larger pub group. Years ago, they were involved in the Firkin pubs. And they raised money through EIS, as they tend to do, built up the business. So it's got about 36 pubs or so, I think, now. And decided it's the right time to float. I expect to be around for 2 or 3 years and somebody will buy it. I mean, there's a danger short term with this kind of company that people who invested in the EIS might want to sort of lock in their gains, so you never know if there might be a bit of selling, but I think it should do pretty well. As I think I said, it's gone to a premium in its first day.
And next week, looking busy, if not busier, on the IPO front, of course, we've got Keystone Law.
Yes, I was speaking to them this morning. They've been around for about 15 years. They're slightly different to a normal law company, because they've got a kind of central part which does all the admin, getting the money to be paid and things like that. And they have these employees, who are the lawyers, who win the work, have the client relationships, so they don't have to worry about the admin. But they only get paid once the company gets paid. So in cash flow terms, it's pretty good for the company. Mm-hmm. And they get paid sort of between about 60% and 3/4 of what's charged, the individual lawyers. It depends on if they've been referred by somebody else, so they might get some of that, might be going to some the referee. And it's a model where they say they don't really have to invest much in the central overhead. They want to get more people just to come and join them. And I think people like working themselves but not having all the hassle. So they're, as I say, they're coming next week. And there's also three others.
That's exactly right. A couple of others. Mirriad Advertising, one of them?
Yes, this is a business I don't know much about. I've only had a quick read through it. But they've got some technology which enables people to put their brands in existing content, which I assume they have to sort of get permission for. They can't be just sticking brands on any old television program and film and putting it up on YouTube. And again, I think this is quite an early stage business. I think they've developed the product, but I'm not sure. I don't get the impression that they've sort of got much in the way of sales yet. Also, there's Beaks Cloud Financial.
Yes.
That's sort of cloud computing services for Forex traders, as far as I can see. That's a Glasgow based business. And the other one is 10 Lifestyle, which is described as concierge services for people. But it seems to be is that brands will kind of, upmarket luxury brands will give their customers sort of this sort of perk, or we give this service, and they sign up for the service and they sort of get all these sort of services from 10 Lifestyle themselves. And there's also a couple of new issues next week as well, potentially.
Or
certainly in
week.
December.
Right.
Anyway, because there's Bella Scura, I always get the name wrong, but you remember Tech Capital?
Yes.
This is the business they've got more than 50% of. And it's medical equipment. They buy up sort of non-core medical technology from people or IP from universities. And so they're on course, I think, for certainly December. I'm not sure if there's a date for that one. It might be sort of the first week, though. And there's Block Energy, which is oil and gas company in Republic of Georgia. That's moving from next sometime in December.
Oh, so plenty of action still left on the IPO front.
Well, yeah, I think they're all trying to get out before Christmas to make sure everything's done, not get too near to them and sort of fail to get everything in order.
Exactly. So leaving the IPOs, the new issues to one side for a moment, you've been out speaking to Bilby. They had their interims out this week, some record numbers in those?
Yeah, so record interims, which is a good recovery from a year or two ago when there was contract delays and problems with their accounting, and that's all been sorted out. They're winning new contracts, they haven't lost any contracts. They're mainly building maintenance, gas installation, electrical services for social housing and some commercial. They're very much focused on London and South East. They won a contract recently which goes to Southampton, which is the furthest they've ever been. And they started off the whole point of them was they were a consolidator. They've had a bit of a, because they had the blip, they haven't been able to do that. But now they've sorted everything out, they should be able to sort of go out and sort of maybe make some deals. They're on a relatively low rating though at the moment in terms of their shares. It's probably about just over eight times prospective earnings.
So looking positive there.
Yeah.
And also Solid State. Not the best of numbers in their interims, but a healthy looking order book. You've been speaking to them as well.
Yes, they were. I think the main problem with the numbers was there was a bit of a downgrade, but that was because the distribution side was doing well and the manufacturing side wasn't doing quite so well. And the problem with that is the distribution of electronic components isn't as high margin as their manufacturing business, which is things like antennas and electrics. Storage and ruggedized computers, that kind of thing.
Right.
And they had a little bit of a sort of a problem in terms of designing their antennas. It took a bit longer to sort things out. They seem to be over that and they should have a better second half. This year profits are going to be flat, probably around about 3 million. But the order book, well, at the end of I think from October, was about 20 million. That sort of stretches out quite a way, and they should sort of start growing their profit again next year, I think.
That's great, Andrew. Look, good to see you as always. Thank you.
Thanks.